All right, here we are, Star Ladder Season 3. Got a winner's match between Cloud9 and Vega Squadron. It's a best of three. Winner qualifies for the European Phase 3. So we get right on into this draft. I'm your caster, B-Cop, here with CC&C. Ready to take on this draft. We see that Cloud9, they've banned out the Underlord, banned out the Weaver, and then for the side of Vega, they've banned out Luna as well as that Venge. So, 10 seconds remaining. Just gonna wait for this first pick. How you doing today, CC&C? 5 seconds.
Doing pretty good. Meeple! Ready to watch some Dota. They did not ban Meeple on Cloud9 first picks, Meeple.
Yeah, we saw it getting banned first phase every game yesterday.
Yeah, the hero is just obscenely strong right now with not having to get Aghanims now. The camps really benefit him. The shrines in the base are really nice as well. Roots being buffed. Just a whole lot of things. The talents are really good. The lifesteal is doing ancients all the time. A whole lot of things just make this hero completely broken right now.
Yeah, and today we do have Baby Knight back for Cloud9. It's not Mad as a stand-in, so it's the full squad this time around. And then right after that, we do see the Vega Squadron have picked up Earth Spirit as well as the Sven. So trying to counter this Meepo a little bit.
5 seconds. Yeah, the Earth Spirit, I think, just to comfort Vega Squadron hero. Sven, obviously, the cleave, very good versus Meepo. I kind of wonder how. Yeah, they immediately picked the Undying, so versus two strength heroes, they obviously want to go aggressive and punish the Sven, shut him down early, and give the Meepo a good start. Maybe keep the Vega Squadron supports pinned down in the safe lane with the Undying. Maybe do some sort of an aggressive dual lane. Because they do have an Earth Spirit, so it's a little bit hard to punish them. Sven, not typically known for his tri-lane prowess. He does only have one stun before he's out of mana, or has to use a Clarity, so.
Alright, so banned out is Jakiro. And then follow that up with Cloud9, they ban out the Winter Wyvern. Of course, they don't want that up against the Meepo. Meepo, Undying, Earth Spirit, Sven. I mean, is either team looking way better than the other right now in this draft?
I don't think one is necessarily looking better than the other, but I think Vega has to play around this Meepo pick, and Cloud9 can do whatever they want. They can pressure the safe lane, or this off lane, shut down this Sven, and then they, you know, hopefully this Meepo will be able to roam free. I'm sure Vega is not gonna stop here. They're gonna pick a few more counters, because this hero is just so insane right now that you need to have a way to deal with it, and if you're gonna let it through, then they have a way that they think they can counter it. So they have a draft framed in mind how they want to play against the people, I'm sure. So I'll have to see how the rest of that plays out. If they want to go for more team fight, go for something like the Warlock. I think they're going to need a pretty strong laner, as they're probably, Cloud9 is probably going to do some sort of Undying dual offlane. So something to strengthen the Sven lane so we can actually get to a good start and get to the point where he does stuff for Meepo before Meepo gets turbo farmed.
Yeah, and that Meepo really knows how to get farm quickly, as you usually see a Meepo come online maybe about 10 to 12 minutes into the game, and Vega, they're gonna ban out that Dazzle, and Cloud9, they ban out the Tinker. Is there any reason that you'd ban out the Tinker? Is it just the rockets up against Meepo? You just don't really want to deal with that, as well as the laser?
You can get Aghanims, and it bounces to all the Meepos, so they just never hit anything. It's good in lane versus Meepo, very good in lane. Before he has like three Meepos and just starts double poofing waves. They may be picking a lineup that doesn't do well versus Tinker. Wow, Phoenix. Yeah, they really. Wow. Alright, so they're just picking a lot of AoE damage. Gonna counter this Meepo that way. The laser, obviously, very, very good versus the Meepos, because, you know, they just sort of die to it along with this. Their Spirit Magnetize, Sven Cleave, so. A lot of AoE, a fair amount of team fight now as well between the Supernova and Magnetize on Vega.
So you've got Phoenix, Supernova, Magnetize for Earth Spirit. What's Cloud9? You know, they're trying to really get at this Meepo on the side of Vega. What do you got to put with this Meepo to really protect him now that they've got both that Phoenix Supernova and the Magnetize for Earth Spirit?
I mean, I think you just want to punish the greediness of Vega. If this Phoenix is support and not offline, then I think you just want to punish the greediness of their two supports and how weak this lane is. And, you know, they picked it on Undying first, too. It's obviously what they want to do. They want to not let them get away with having these very, very greedy supports with all this damage once they get their levels. Yeah, Sand King and dying dual offlane can just be brutal, and I don't know if these three heroes can deal with it, so we'll have to see how Vega lands this, or how they enable this Sven, because Sven is not a hero that can play from behind. It's a hero that really needs to be ahead, have the space to farm up the Ancients, get to a couple of core items before he can actually have an impact, so let's see.
Yeah, to me, with the draft that Vega's kind of rolling with now, maybe they purposely left that Meepo open. And they knew they might be able to counter it with the draft they're picking up right now.
Yeah, I mean, if you're not banning Meepo versus a team that plays Meepo, then you definitely have a plan, or you're insane, because that hero, you need to have a plan to deal with that hero, because it's just so good right now.
So, Earth Spirit, Sven, Phoenix. I mean, what's your thoughts on really where they go next with this draft if they're really just trying to hard counter this Meepo with their entire draft?
I don't know if they're going to counter it with their entire draft. We'll have to see. I'm not sure if this Phoenix is support or offlane right now. I'd assume it's support, as if you pick offlane, okay, so it is support. So yeah, just more team fight, more AoE damage. Now with the Vac Wall on top of all the spells, so they can combo it up with the Sven Stun, with the Earth Spirit Kick, and then have the laser over the top, Phoenix Spit Things, Egg damage, so a whole lot of potential for massive AoE damage. And it's definitely not a game that Meepo is going to enjoy playing against. I also like the Starkster pick because it gives them a very strong laner. So if they do choose to go for some aggressive dual lane, which it looks like they're doing, then the Darkster will be able to thrive in this offlane. But I really, really like Cloud9's Silencer pick because they do pick, because the Silencer is, you know, one of the best heroes at solo zoning and offlaner. So by picking that, it sort of counters this Darkster pick, not in the teamfight way, but it's going to at least make his laning life miserable. So Cloud9's safe laner will be enabled, and then also be able to pick, you know, some mid. As Vega Squadron does have the last pick, so they won't be able to have the matchup they want, but the Silencer counters this Darkster in lane and will be able to zone him really, really well while they have this dual offlane going on.
You think with a, and I'm getting used to just asking it every game, with the Sven and the Darkseer, are they going to roll that Darkseer in the safe lane, Sven in the off lane, or Sven one of those heroes who really can't get away with that?
I think it'll have to depend. I'm not really sure. They may try and dodge and put the Darkseer versus the Undying Sand King. I think it's their intentions and what's going to happen may be different. They have to, sort of depends on who gets the deep wards done, who knows where the lands are going, so they can, you know, set up how they want to. But Cloud9 definitely wants this Undying Sand King versus the Earth Spirit Sven Phoenix, I think.
All right, and last ban from Vega is going to be that Oracle. They banned out the Dazzle, they banned out the Oracle. They really don't want to let anybody stay alive longer than they need to be. And, you know, Vega, they're looking for a mid-hero, something that Cloud9 should really ban out right now, that they just really don't want their Meepo up against, or they just gonna ban maybe somebody's best player on the side of Vega?
They may just ban us, yeah, just a solid mid-hero. Lanes very well versus a lot of heroes. The SF also may be good for whatever Cloud9 picks for mid right now. They may be picking some Ember Spirit, something like that. Although Vega do have a lot of ways to break the shield reasonably quickly, I think Ember is still quite good here, as it's very, very hard for him to die with Vega's current heroes in the SF, known for being very good versus the Ember in lane. It's very hard for the Ember to push up onto the enemy team whenever the SF is ahead, because you can start to get right-clicked down. Overall, it's just not a super fun matchup for Ember. The SF versus Ember matchup in lane is SF favored, but it is skill-based, so you know, just not wanting to have to deal with that kind of a difficult matchup, I guess. Remaining. Or just, you know, just in general, as a good hero and works for their lineup and sort of the five-man style they have.
All right, so Pugna's going to be the last pick. Wow. Radiant team pick. So where do you see these heroes for Cloud9 going now that they've picked up Pugna last?
They could run Pugna mid or Meepo's mid. I think both are viable. I think it kind of depends on what Vega picks here for 10 seconds remaining. Their mid. And they'll sort of decide whether they want to put this Pugna or Meepo mid, which one's safe lane. I think the Undying Sand King still goes dual offlane. and that's the silencer, and then one of the two goes to their safe lane. But yeah, I think a lot of it does come down to what Vega last picks here. We'll have to see.
Anything you're hoping for the side of Vega to pick up last? It's going to be that Lifestealer.
So, Sven mid, looks like. Okay, so they're mixing it up. They realize that if they put the Sven in the safe line versus a dying Sand King, they're just going to get completely massacred. My sort of worry is that he's going to get massacred in this Pugna lane too. They can rotate in with the Earth Spirit, maybe try and kill him. If the Sven gets more than 1 point in Stormbolt, 2 or 3 points, they can maybe get a kill on the Pugna. But other than that, I feel like the Sven, there's just really no home for him to be in. No matter what lane he goes to, it could be get messy. It could also be a Lifestealer mid, which would do a little bit better. Because you'd have Rage, so it's sort of hard for him to blast you down. And also, you know, much harder for him to threaten a kill on you at some point. So it could also be a Lifestealer mid, but the way Vega Squadron's lanes are going to turn out just sort of worries me. If they can get to this mid game intact, then they can definitely deal with this Meepo. But the Nether Ward also really, really good versus the three non-Svens of Vega Squadron.
All right, so we get into this first game.
Very good versus physical damage.
Any shot that it's, I mean, just a crazy lineup. They go with something like a support Sven or something like that, something stupid.
Oh, okay. It's I forgot that Cloud9 does this. It's support Pugna and it's mid silencer.
Oh, okay.
So it is mid Sven as well. So the silencer is gonna have a very good time against the Sven, and the support Pugna looks like he'll be down in this duel offlane, or maybe even an aggressive tri-lane with the Meepo solo. That's what it's looking like now. We'll have to see if one of them rotates up after a little bit. But yeah, I'd forgotten Cloud9 do this, so is there going to be the support partner?
Alright, so with that, we got Dityura on the Lifestealer, Seema on the Phoenix. For this Sven, it's going to be G, and Sineko on the Earth Spirit once again, and Mag on that Darkseer, as we saw him play amazingly yesterday. For the side of C9, Ace is going to be on that Meepo, Baby Knight on the Silencer, Noya on the Undying Rise with the Pugna, and finally, with that Sand King, it's going to be Hesta Joe here in this best of three. Winner of this best of three does qualify for the next phase, and should line up to be a good one. Both teams played very well yesterday, and I'm hoping they both bring their best into this best of three, and we see some really good Dota coming out. So right away we see Baby Knight, Ryze, Hesta Joe, and Noya come towards this bottom bounty rune. Dityura and the Phoenix do have to bail out, and we'll be giving up that bounty rune and going back towards this one. Over on their side is Sineko to pick it up. So still just 2 for 2 terms of bounty runes.
Yeah, I really like this the core silencer. This Sineko.
As the Joe is gonna find Sineko. Sineko got a little greedy going for this bounty rune on the opposite side of the river. He does find most of the side of C9. Has the Joe, Noya, as well as Baby Knight are gonna find him and bring him down. So it's quick first blood for C9. Meanwhile, mid, there's gonna be a rolling boulder in from Sineko. They're trying to get a kill on Baby Knight. There's the Storm Hammer. Coming in with the Icarus dive is Seema. Baby Knight looks all but dead, and he will finally fall as Sineko grabs that last hit, and it's now right back to even at one apiece.
Yeah, I really like that early gank mid. Realizing that them being there, the first wave doesn't really do too much. It's a Lifestealer level 1, so he should be fine versus Undying very early on. And the Sven really needs a head start to do well in this lane versus Silencer, because once he starts getting some levels up, he's just going to just constantly pepper him with the glaives, and it's not going to be enjoyable for the Sven.
Looking forward again, Sineko going to go in with that rolling boulder. Both going to eat their ironwood branches, get those happy trees out there, get that regen, and there's no follow-up. Looked as though maybe G didn't have enough mana for that Stormhammer follow-up, so like you said, it's usually one and done with Sven.
If the Silencer does get a lot of farm this game, I think he could have an extremely high impact. Very good versus both Sven and Lifestealer. Super good at kiting him with the extremely long attack range. The Silence, very good versus Lifestealer, and all of Vega's supporting cast as well. Silencer overall, just a very good pick this game. Even if it was safe lane support, could have been very, very good. But I think I like it even more in this mid position, as the Pugna in this mid game would dive very, very easily to a lot of Vega's magic damage. So up to me with the Silencer mid.
Again with that Rolling Boulder, get the stun. Baby Knight looking to get out. He will just back off with about 75 health. Just gets that Curse of the Silent off on both G and Sineko. They're really looking for this kill, and they're being very aggressive in this mid lane. They'll shrine up, get their mana back up to close to full. And with that, they can try again, looking for that Rolling Boulder, Stormhammer, as well as the stun on Baby Knight. So they're just keeping the aggression up on Baby Knight, and that's not hurting his farm terribly. I mean, he is only 2-1, so it does kind of just suck to be mid-Baby Knight right now on this Silencer. But what do you think he does now that he's got Noya in his lane as well, kind of babysitting?
I mean, he just continues to farm, chill. Once he gets some levels, he'll be able to pressure the Sven. You know, you can see already the Sven not really enjoying being in this lane, and the Sand King having a decent time 1v1 bottom down versus the Lifestealer. Now that the Undying is left life, he's going to be in
trouble
some
as he gets hit by that Stormhammer, as well as the Rolling Boulder. Icarus dive over the top from Seema. A couple more shots should do it, and they will get the kill split between the three of them. Now, Baby Knight might be a little bit too far out, but not enough mana for that Stormhammer once again. And Baby Knight should survive, but they give up another kill in this mid lane. This time it's going to be Noya.
Yeah, just a little too far out, goes down. With the Meepo being such an incredible jungler as he is, once he gets level 3, they're actually putting the Pugna in the safe lane as well, and the Meepo just going to the jungle after starting in the safe lane, so the Pugna is going to get quite a few levels. It's going to be able to deal with the Starks who are pushing the lane out with Ion Shells. He can just pull it behind the tower and then nuke the wave down. And also this Pugna is not going to be super far behind, it's actually going to have some good levels. And, you know, overall just be like able to have an impact in this mid game because they are giving him a start in the safe lane. So overall, I just really, really like the laning stage from Cloud9. This mid lane is not going so well, but that's sort of the Vega's only bright spot right now, is how much pressure they're putting on mid. They've gotten a few kills, but overall, I think the early game favors Cloud9 a fair amount.
Get the Burrow Strike down low on this Lifestealer. Diggerah might be in a little bit of trouble. Here comes Noya. He's going to use those open wounds on Ahesta Joe. He's going to drop the Tombstone. They're really looking to get a kill on Diggerah, but the stun comes out from on two from Sineko, and it will keep Diggerah alive, but he will give up his life as Ahesta Joe gets that Burrow Strike out on Sineko. And they do get themselves at least one down low as Diggerah really getting close to death there with about 150 health. Gets saved by Sineko, who gave up his life for the greater good.
Yeah, he just wants to sit in here and get his level 6 so we can heal up to full, but C9 with the scan, fine. They know he's in here.
Yeah, there it is, Burrow Strike with the decay, and they still find Diggerah anyway, so all for nothing on Sineko's part. He does keep him alive for a little bit longer, a little bit more XP goes his way, but he does end up falling in the end to both Ahesta Joe and Noya.
Baby Knight TPing off the top, trying to make something happen, get a kill on Mag, as he's really not getting it. Oh. Okay, Snow looks like he's just going to sit and farm up top. It's just going to be his home now, because he really can't lane versus the Sven or Spirit just sitting there anymore. He walks up, he's almost certainly going to die to the roll, the stun follow up, and the Phoenix is there to dive in Spirit. So, going to come off the top. We'll have a hard time against this Darkseer, but we'll be getting more than he was mid, so getting the Silencer as much as he can at this point. He's the only hero on their team really struggling, so trying to enable him, and in the mid game, Sand King is having a really good game as Undying.
Wow, they drop the wall for Ryze as Sineko comes in with the Rolling Boulder. One shot till Sineko goes down, there's the Soul Rip, and Noya gets yet another kill, and Baby Knight's here with the Arcane Curse. Mag gonna have to surge himself out, and they're still continuing to chase. Dire's middle tower is under
attack. Yeah, I don't think there's any real way they get that kill. They don't have anything to deal with the surge other than this the nuts and the stun from Sand King, and either of those heroes there, so.
I'm not too sure. I didn't think they needed to drop the wall on that. Maybe a misclick of some sort. Maybe they really just wanted it. Meanwhile, down low, open wounds is on Ahesta Joe. They're trying to get the kill on this Sand King, but here comes the Arcane Curse from Baby Knight. Maybe they look to turn this around. It seems very low on this Phoenix. There's the last word popping, and he will fall to Baby Knight. Ahesta Joe still looking for a stun. He might find one on Sineko. He's just a little too far out of range, and now Noya coming in from the back end. He is invis, and they do spot out Sineko, so this might be the end for him as Ahesta Joe's making his way over, going to eat that tree, try and get himself some space, but the stun comes out on two from Sineko, and he will be able to Rolling Boulder himself to safety by this shrine. Noya still going in on this.
Yeah, at the very least, Baby Knight now in this bottom lane with the Sand King. So, the Sand King gonna slow down his blink a little bit, but it's gonna make some space for Baby Knight. Sand King already very farmed. And the Silencer are gonna have a really nice time down in this bottom lane, gonna be able to get quite a few creeps. Ryze defending mid. So, overall, they're just switching their lanes nonstop based on the situation, not being super stuck in one lane or another. And it's really paying off. They're getting a lot of kills. They're gonna get this bottom tower now. So, just being really, like, just extremely flexible with their lanes. Always reading the situation correctly and not leaving a hero in a bad place for too long. I really, really, really like the landing stage from Cloud9. Also, minus two.
Yeah, the life steward goes down. I missed that one. I don't know how. Freak accidents when I miss kills on cam. Dire's top tower is under attack. Take a look down low. Looks as though Baby Knight and Noir are going to make their way over mid. Maybe want to go in on this Sven. But the ward is here from Vega. They're going to spot out Noir. Noir just going to pick up this bounty rune. And Baby Knight looks as though he's just going to continue to farm. Grab this bounty rune as well. So everything seemed to calm down for both sides. They're just trying to farm up, get those next items for everybody.
Yeah, one of the bright spots of Vega is that G is having a very good game. Is about to close in on that armlet, so 4,100 net worth, just on par with the Meepo. So, has had a lot of support from their Spirit and the Phoenix this game, but is paying off. He is very farmed, so trying to enable their big counter versus the Meepo. And, you know, Sven in the later game can just absolutely annihilate this Meepo. The armor for his team works extremely well against the Meepo. Has a very long AoE stun, so AoE control extremely good versus the Meepo, as well combined with all the damage they have. So the Sven being enabled and gonna go for the Mask of Madness next. So gonna speed up that farming and, you know, give him even more damage, give him some lifesteal, as maybe he doesn't want to go for the HOD this game. Wants to do Ancients more, get more attack speed. You know, overall, Mask of Madness is just a pretty good item on Sven as well.
How long do you think we wait until we kind of see Ace involved in the team fights? We, you know, we've seen the rest of his team involved in getting these six kills for the side of Cloud9, and Ace has really just been off and farming, and he's got himself that early Dragonlance and looking for more. But do you think with that one Dragonlance he can find himself something? Meanwhile, mid Stormhammer comes out on Baby Knight. They will find themselves a kill. The Tombstone is down. They miss the Burrow Strike from Hesta Joe. Global Silence comes out as well. Doesn't look like they're going to get anything on the side of C9 towards Vega as they get one on Baby Knight.
Yep, Ace continuing to push top, having his two Meepos jungling. The right side of the map just killed the Ancients, and I'm moving back over to the Dire Jungle. So has that second Dragonlance already. So two Dragonlances and Treads at 10 minutes, level 12. This Meepo on track to get completely out of control. Is gonna have to play sort of around the Sven. Gonna be looking to maybe split push more, pick and choose his fights very carefully so that he doesn't die to all this AoE damage. But a very nice thing about the Silencer pick as well is that it gives his Meepo sort of a free one or two kills at the start of every fight. He can blink in, poof all his Meepos in, and the Silencer globals right when he jumps. So with the nets, can just, you know, lock one hero down, lock two heroes down, kill them, and then the global will wear off, and, you know, they'll be short one or two heroes to kill this Meepo. So if he does jump the supports at the beginning of every fight, jumps the Sven, jumps the, you know, whoever it may be based on the situation, has the global to always back him up. So it'll be very, very difficult for this Meepo to die in team fights as well, which is sort of what Vega's strength is.
Just taking a look down low, it's T-Rod. He was very poor. Meanwhile, mid, there's a Burrow Strike that comes out on Sinego. Sinego might be in a little bit of trouble. The Sunray is there. The Rolling Boulder is going to be blocked by Hesta Joe. It should be an easy kill. And Baby Knight will get credit for the kill on Sinego. They also get that mid-tier one. And it's looking pretty good for C9 right now. They are up about 3,000 in the XP category and 4,000 net worth. So things are looking pretty solid for C9, and they're kind of fighting 4v5 right now without Ace.
Yeah, Meepo just continuing to farming the right side of the map camps, as well as the left at the same time, and the lane. Just moving his two Meepos around and keeping this one all by himself. And Vega would like to be able to gank this one Meepo, but They're putting so much pressure in the other lanes. He's always shoveling this out. He's now going to go back to the jungle and meet his other meeples and give the Pugna some more time in lane. Looks like he's going for a drum. He's pretty close to it now. Just 1,000 gold away. And the meeple is just continuing to jungle, stay off the map. Has the two dragon lances and 1,900 gold now, so almost the blink on top of it. But Vega's having none of that. He's going to try and get a smoke gank on this meeple before he gets too out of control.
They're going to look to find a kill. There's the Icarus dive with the rolling boulder. They've got the supernova there onto Ace, who's trapped between these ancients, and he will fall to G. And they finally stop this farming of Ace on the meepo, but to me, you compare the net worth of this meepo and the lifestealer, they're still far behind this one kill. They got to continue to do it again and again if they really want to make it worth it.
Yeah, it does at least. Let this fan catch up a little bit. They get some damage on this mid tower, and the global is used. Sneeko missing a boulder up top. Almost able to kill Ryze if he had hit that boulder, so a little unfortunate. Yeah, just buying their team some more farm time. You know, then the big point for Cloud9 is whenever this Meepo feels confident to get Rosh on, they've taken enough towers, and the Meepo kills Rosh, and they just try and walk down all the lanes, take a team fight, and then end the game with his meepo. So Vega knows this timing, needs to play around that and try their hardest to keep this meepo from getting Rosh once he feels strong enough. But looks like he's gonna come up to top lane and try and take a fight around here, not showing with his blink yet.
And so gonna sip that.
Can get all three of them on top of him at once.
I mean, they take these towers pretty quickly, and it feels like that Vega, they've got to do something, otherwise they're just going to continue to lose tower after tower if they don't defend, and they just go down so fast, there's really not much that Vega can do with an underfarmed Nyx and everything else.
Yeah, Vega really wanted the Sven to get to his armor, his Mascomanus, and the Blink Dagger. That was sort of the timing they were looking for, so they could, you know, wombo combo, but without that blink.
Rolling boulder with the infest, he'll finally pop out, but Sineko, he's already dead. Dira's gonna have to use that rage and try and get out. He's gonna try and kill the tombstone. There is a big vacuum wall coming out from Mag. They're gonna try and turn it around now. G coming in, he's got one, he's got two, and now it looks as though that Cloud9 have turned this a bit around as the Phoenix with that Sunray trying to kill off Ace. And he will, it's a 3-for-3 trade. It looked as though Cloud9 had it, taking down three immediately. And now Baby Knight might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the kill from G. He's now dominating. They take out four on the side of Cloud9. So, 3-for-4 trade in favor of Vega. And they might actually get more with, looked as though Sineko was looking for this Undying, but he's not going to come that way.
Yeah, there's that insane team fight we talked about. They hit the massive vacuum wall, huge play from Mag, sort of saves this push. They really needed to defend this tower. They would just continue to lose map control, like you said, give up all their towers, and they'd be in a really rough spot. But a really, really nice team fight, and this is all sort of aftermath of Baby Knight only being level 8, working on an HOD, but only 4k net worth as well, shutting him down like just absolutely masterfully. So the silencer being extremely poor, so Cloud9 basically only having like 1.5 cores, and it's sort of paying there, for it. The Sven was very, very slow, walked around, not doing anything for a majority of that fight, but Baby Knight just not able to dish out the damage during that time because of the poor landing stage he had. So after that fight, Vega very much back into this game, and the Sven now with the blink, he'll be working on the BKB next, and with that BKB, he'll be almost untouchable in these team fights.
Yeah, early in that fight, it looked as though it was going to go C9's way. They had taken out three pretty quickly. And then with almost fine G.
Spidey senses.
And we were talking about that yesterday. It seems as though some of these players, they really just have it. They can just sense when danger is coming. I know people make fun of it, but it definitely seems true at times.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think there were any heroes showing on the map. He had pulled the Mud Golem camps down through this hook here, so it was harder for him to see, and Essigo turned the corner and just barely blinked away. So nice play from G, farming at the right spots, farming in spots where smokes break. It's hard to see where he's farming at.
Are gonna drop this tombstone. Ace moving forward just a little bit. There's the Burrow Strike, but it is way off the mark. Now Sino's here with the Phoenix. He's gonna infest. Maybe they will turn around. There's the Arcane Curse. Here comes G, blinks in, and he's gonna hit Baby Knight to his demise really quickly. So they've got one thus far, and now the Epicenter are getting charged up by Hested Joe. It's going to be to Mag, not really doing too much. There's a Supernova getting popped by Seema. They will bring down Ace, and Vega, they've completely turned around this team fight. They've got the Stormhammer coming out on Pugna, and they will bring down another as three fall on the side of C9. So Vega, you get three kills, and after the previous fight before this, they've really turned around this game.
Yeah, like we said, if you aren't banning evil, then you have the strategy to play against it, and they really do here. Oh, it's like what's happening a lot of TIs. If there's this hero that you're just so scared of, you have to ban every game, sort of a niche pick, and you just have to ban it every game, then they just sort of get away with it, and you have to waste a ban every first ban phase. But if you let it through and you beat it with a strategy you've built up, then they're sort of scared to pick it in the future. So you sort of just, for future games against Cloud9, have made drafting a lot easier, or have opened up other picks maybe they want to take. So overall, a very, very good strategy from Vega. And after these past couple of team fights, the Meepo not so high in net worth anymore, only up to 9k. Sven above him now, and the Sven well on his way to a BKB. So with that completed, these team fights are going to be looking quite grim for Cloud9, even with the extremely strong team fight of their lineup.
And DRI, he's finding himself enough space, and with these team fights that they're winning, he's getting himself back in it in terms of net worth, as he was down to like 4,300 net worth about 5 minutes ago, so, or maybe less than that. So he's really starting to pull it back. And I'll have a lifestealer to really help out this Sven.
Yep, has 2k gold on top of the Blight Sun, so probably going to be going for that Deso. Going to make bursting these meatballs and these squishy supports with low armor even easier. Baby Knight, only 6 armor, but they are going to go for this Roshan. So, like we talked about, Meepo extremely good at getting the Roshan, is level 15, so has the Lifesteal talent, and is going to make killing this Roshan very easy, barely even going to lose any HP, and that's sort of Cloud9's ticket back into these team fights, away from them to take them again. This Meepo has 2 lives, maybe kill a couple of supports, die, and then come back and finish off the rest of the fight. So, a nice sneak from Cloud9. Got their lanes up before they did it. This mid lane pushed out very far, so Vega not really able to do too much off of that. This bottom lane pushed out.
Do you think the Aegis really helps this Meepo though? It seems like they're just getting melted in team fights to the point where a second life only extends the inevitable, where Vega's just melting the side of C9 and really just destroying in fights.
I think it gives this Meepo the opportunity to jump one or two squishy supports, kill them, then he goes down and the rest of the team goes in, they finish off the team fight that way. Have the Meepo starting off, sort of being isolated almost, trying to pick heroes off, trying to, blow them up at the start of the fight. He goes down, so that way he can sort of be more aggressive in these fights, suiciding and not be so scared.
Enon Seneca will just get the poof and get the easy kill on the Earth Spirit Seneca, sorry about that.
Yeah, and just do sort of things like this, getting these pickoffs, and now Vega really has to be a little bit worried. It's only one Earth Spirit down, and he's a very, very short respawn timer, as he is only level 8. So not the biggest deal in the world, but they're going to get the mid tier 2. Vega, or Steam of the Slayer, pushing in bottom, doing the laser and then TP out, so getting this wave all the way into the tower, and the Undying can't actually cancels his TP, so it looks like Cloud9 wants to stick around and fight, don't want to deal with this bottom lane right now. They really want to, they want to punish Vega around this area, and maybe take more map control, try and even break base if they take a good fight here.
Meanwhile, Mag is trying to push up top, trying to force C9 back in some way, because they can definitely feel the pressure coming in mid. I'm not too sure they're ready to fight just yet to defend that high ground.
As we say that, Mag TP's back, looks like they may smoke out the dude. See that sanking illusion, so we can wait till it dies so it doesn't see the smoke edge over the cliff. And looks like they're going to run straight up to top, pushing the lane in and going smoke to it, because they know that someone's going to be pushing it out. So a nice move from them. They'll have the ion shell on this wave mid. Actually, they're not, so I'm not going to give them a chance of giving it away, but I think Cloud9 may have seen the ion shell damage a little bit, so booking it away. Oh, Baby Knight making Cloud9.
There's the rolling boulder coming in. The silence is out on Baby Knight. There's the infest pop, and it's an easy kill on Baby Knight. Ryze might be in a little bit of trouble. He just gets himself out. And Vega with an easy pickoff on Baby Knight might look to push this top tower.
Yep, Ace immediately going to start split pushing bottom. It looks like Looks like Vega maybe want to catch them, this bottom lane, so pushing out their lanes and immediately just going to try and fight them. And every step of the way, is she does have that BKB now, so extremely strong in these fights. The Lifestealer has an Echo Saber, going to be working on Sajin Yasha now, looks like. So he's actually going to be mobile against these Meepo nets, going to be able to get on top of the Meepo, versus all these kiting spells, be able to move around better in these fights, get on top of the targets he wants to. Overall, you know, mobility in these fights for Vega is absolutely huge.
Link Burrow strike in, Ace with the poops. They're trying to bring down G. He does pop that BKB, but just a little too late as Ace gets the kill onto G, and now they look towards grabbing this bottom tier 2. Might even look for more as this spends down for 50 seconds. They're going to try and push this high ground on the bottom tier 3, maybe try and check if he has that buyback, and if he doesn't buy back, just continue to put full pressure on it.
Yeah, he doesn't have buyback, so they may actually lose Rax here. The Aegis on the Meepo, like we talked about, lets him do this. If he didn't have Aegis, they can just go on a full commit, kill the Meepo, and you know, think life would be easy, but the Meepo has the E-Blade, so a ton of damage on every Meepo, and just chain-gunning down these Rax, and a little apprehensive, but tossing out some nets.
And they do get the poof in and immediately kill Seema. He's going to buy back. There's the vacuum wall on a bunch, and now they're looking for more. It looks as though Dikaraz is going to fall. He's going to be the next one to go down. They're looking for something as the Magnetize comes out on, from Sonaco onto C9. Doesn't look to be doing enough, and even if it does bring down Ace, he's still got that Aegis alive, and it's just Mag, Sonaco, and Seema to defend this Rax, and they've already lost it. They do end up popping the Aegis. They might want to move in on this. There's the Icarus dive forward, and the Epicenter comes in from Hesta Joe, but really towards the end. Seema's going to go down to Ryze. They're trying to get Hesta Joe, who's going to be soul ripped back to about full health. There's the mech used. Sonaco goes down. G going to pop that BKB. There's another vacuum, as well as the cleave damage from G will bring down Ace. And now they're looking for more as Ryze is trying to run away. He's got that Ion Shell on G. G's got that God Strike. There's the Burrow Strike. And there is the Decay. The last word comes out on G. G might be in a little bit of trouble. It's just Hesta Joe, Ryze, Baby Knight, and Noya. They're trying to turn this around on G. Mag might be a little bit too far out as they do get the Burrow Strike. And a couple more hits from Baby Knight will do it. And only two are alive for the side of Vega. That's Dikaraz on G. Dikaraz going to hit away at Noya. Noya gonna ghost scepter himself, or gonna get ghost sceptered and leave. Or not ghost sceptered, decrepified.
Yeah, that's the power of this Meepo, playing around this BKB, not taking these 5-man fights where Vega's able to set up and get their spells off, but instead just jumping the Sven not having buyback, and they're really paying for it there. This Aegis on the Meepo just paying massive dividends and getting them entire racks there, and really swinging the net worth lead sort of back the other way, and you know, Vega still in a good spot. Net worth wise, not as good as they were before, but they really have to be careful. It's the game definitely not over, but you know, they're playing with a knife's edge. You lose one more fight, and you lose another racks. Meepo just takes building so incredibly fast with that E-Blade and the Dragon Lances.
We still do have the buyback on G. It's available if Dikaraz can get 94 more gold. It shouldn't be too hard. Do you think C9 really sit back and wait for another Aegis, or do they continue to put the pressure on? And while I say that, they're going to smoke up, so I feel like I kind of got my answer right there.
Yeah, they want to get on top of G. They want to, you know, blow a hero up at the beginning of this fight, global, and get a free kill that way.
Seema, he's going to use that supernova. That's really not going to help. There's the BKB with another big vacuum wall. Stormhammer, the cleave takes out the entire side of C9 just like that. And they'll give up Seema for the full team wipe on C9. A great turnaround by Vega. Woo!
That's not how they want to take the fight.
That was a blink of an eye. Turn that around. Vacuum wall comes in from Mag. Stormhammer, as well as the God Strength Greater Cleave from G. They kill the entire side of C9 and completely turn the game around just like that.
Yeah, the silencer got caught into the vacuum wall slightly out of position, so he gets caught, isn't able to global and counter it up, and just completely turns it around. They get a 5-man wipe, and now the tables have been turned. G hitting on the high ground, doesn't have the God Strength because he didn't use it in that last fight, and some of Cloud9's heroes respawning, everyone but the Meepo, so they may have to back up, play it safe after that really good team fight. G working on the Daedalus now as well, if he does go for that, has the Crystallis, so probably going to be that Daedalus, and you know, gonna make those big Wumble combos kill Cloud9 even faster. Just wants a couple of shots on this Meepo and will kill him and basically the rest of his entire team. And Vega, they don't want to just leave. They want to punish. And they figure Cloud9 is going to move out in their right. Sitting on this hill, going to try and catch someone. Hestijoe moving slightly in the wrong direction for them.
Sineko's going to be there with the Infest. There's the Stormhammer, and the Infest immediately pop. They'll take out Baby Knight. They're looking for more. There's the Rolling Boulder. Tombstone's dropped to the high ground. Noia might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Vacuum. He will get the kill. And G finds another. And now the Burrow Strike comes out on three from Hestijoe. He'll four staff to the high ground and leave with a little bit of ease.
Yep, they sit back on the hill, realize that Cloud9 is probably going to push out. They want to make something happen. They don't want to let Vega chill and get a bunch of items up. As the Lifestealer continuing to build up items, the spend, getting very, very farmed, getting to that one-shot territory. But, you know, catching Baby Knight, as well as the Undying, so going to get this Tier 3 tower and then back up again. Maybe look to turn once again on this hill, or, you know, just stay around this area, try and get the lanes out, just hold control of Cloud9's side of the map.
Do back off just a bit. They're gonna check Roche, not up for a little while, and I think maybe the plan for Vega might be to sit back a little bit, farm, go get that Roche, and finish off the game if they can do so.
Yeah, we'll have to see. Mag shoving in this top lane has 3600 gold, so it's gonna have the Blink Dagger and make these fights extremely hard for Cloud9 to not get vacuum walls. He's always gonna be just sitting there waiting, and as soon as the global wears off, they don't get the global wall, gonna jump in and get that back wall. And it doesn't even have to be on five heroes, just one or two is enough. As Sven will cleave them down, they'll be able to take the fight from there. Although five, as we saw last fight, is optimal. Ace continuing to just farm up the entire map, one Meepo in each camp, and the main Meepo walking around looking for rotations, potentially going for that Scotty next. So gonna try and kite the cores of Vega even more, but this Meepo really needs to have the advantage in some of these fights. Like, he has to jump in and get on top of a hero and force them to run away. If they can just turn and fight him, then he's gonna get slaughtered by the Sven and their magic damage. So they have to be in a position where they're chasing Vega down. If they're not chasing them and Vega turns to fight them, then this fight could turn grim for Cloud9 very, very quickly.
And we've seen that happen about two times in a row now, as G as well as Mag have set up just huge team fights for the side of Vega and wiped C9. So we definitely see that when Vega, they kind of not getting chased back into their base, they seem to have the upper hand in this game right now.
Yeah, we'll have to see. Like we saw earlier, with a Meepo, you can get a pick off, and then the game just instantly turns around, and they both know, or whose creep is that? Okay, so that's Baby Knight's creep. So Dire knows Roche is up. I don't think Vega does, so they both know that Roche is extremely important, both getting wards up around this area. Dire with slightly better vision, seeing the Lifestealer here, so both teams going to start playing around this Roshan, and if Vega can get that, then it'll be, the game will be very, very, it'll be considerably easy for them to play out, whereas Cloud9 really needs that to have a glimmer of hope, or it's just too easy for this Meeple to die. So a super focal point here, and Vega may be able to close out this game if they do manage to get the Aegis.
They did spot out Ryze for a second, so they're going to know that C9 are just sitting towards this Roche pit. Of course, you know, Ace has a couple of Meepos down low, but he's ready to poof him right on back. It definitely seems the battle of who goes in first on this Roche pit.
Yeah, Ace having the right ID here, as well as Hestijoe pushing in this bottom lane, so while this Roche standoff goes down, going to start splitting bottom and force someone to rotate over, so not going to give Vega the opportunity to have all five heroes there. Zay splitting top as well, but might actually get caught.
Sineko, I'm not too sure he spots him just yet. Mag's coming over, Sineko's infested, so they might be able to get a kill on Ace if they do go in on this right now. There's the Blink in with the Magnetized. Infest comes in with the Vacuum, but Sineko completely gets turned around on, and he's going to fall first. Ace is going to get very low. The wall is dropped. Global Silence comes out a little bit too late, and Ace will pay the price, and Dittura is going to get credit for that one.
Yeah, he almost turned and killed all three of them, but focusing the right one, making sure they don't split their any of their damage, and takes the Meepo down, and now gonna try and get this bottom lane out, force Hestijoe out of it, so they maybe can take this Roshan once Sineko spawns. So a very, very nice pickoff from Cloud9, and Meepo does have this buyback, but I don't think he wants to use it, so
without their Meepo. Maybe they give up Roche. There's a Storm Hammer. Decrepified is G, but they're still trying to go in on Ryze. He's going to use that Glimmer Cape to find himself a bit of an escape. So he's there with Noya, pushing up his Seema on this Phoenix, and going over towards Roche is G. They know that Meepo's still down, and he hasn't fought back just yet, so you get the feeling he's just not going to, and they'll move their way into Roche and look for this Aegis.
Yep, dying very, very quickly, already at half HP. Looks like Digira is going to be the one taking this, since he does have a slot freed up in G. Oh!
Digira still going to get that Aegis. Rolling Boulder out with the Dust. Hesta Joe going to be in a lot of trouble. There's the Storm Hammer, and one swipe is going to be there from G, and he will get the kill on Hesta Joe.
Yeah, so Cloud9 feeling the pressure. You can tell the Sand King really wanted to take this Aegis. Maybe give Cloud9 a better shot at one of these next teamfights, but with the Meepo without the Aegis and the Lifestealer with it, they really have to get an amazing initiation. I also really like this Lifestealer going for the Mantle. It's now also able to burn off the Silence, burn off the Decrepify if it does get put on the Lifestealer, purge off of all the Silencers, slows, as well as purge the Meepo net. So overall, just a very good pickoff and lets him be much more mobile in these fights and actually get on top of heroes.
And there's no Ags on this Meepo. You think that might be holding him back just a little bit?
I don't think it matters too much. Just the one Meepo going for this Hex is sort of the play they have to make, so that way they can maybe set up around the map, get some pickoffs, and be able to take the base in sort of a 4v5 scenario, 3v5 scenario. Because in a 5v5, it's very unlikely that Cloud9 are able to take a fight if Vega has vision, if they're able to get the jump, or even just some semblance of a jump. G with the Bloodthorn now as well, so able to actually kill this Pugna without getting decrepified. Able to jump this Undying and just two-shot him. Very good versus all of their heroes. And the Silence is going to pay dividends as well. There's not many ways to purge it off on Cloud9 at all. In fact, there's no ways to purge it off except for the Guardian Greaves on Undying, but that's just him.
Yeah. So they're going to push bottom, look for this tier 2. Should be an easy tower for them. As of right now, it doesn't look like C9's going to make any rotations. I'm not too sure they want to fight out of their base, especially with the Aegis out on Vega for Digira. Meanwhile, mid, it looks as though Ryze is going to push this creep wave, try and counter push just a little bit. Sineko's over to try and clean it up, and he does have the infest of Digira on him at the moment. So if they could find out Ryze or find one of the heroes on C9, which they're trying to do with that rolling boulder to the high ground, they are going to spot Ryze. Do get the stun despite having the Glimmer Cape, and now there's the Sunray from Seema. They will get the kill from Digira. Everybody just makes the rotation over, and they do find yet another kill on C9. This time it's going to be Ryze.
Yeah, the gem on Sunico paying dividends. You got to check around and look for some of these wards, but Cloud9 with some very nice deep wards, able to scout where Vega is going to push out these lanes. They can push out the other lanes. Let's them also maybe scout for some pickoffs at Hesta Joe. Maybe the wrong place at the wrong time.
Hesta Joe will be able to TP out to your with the basher, so.
Sneaky had gone the other direction to D ward. Maybe a little bit of miscommunication, but he also have had his stun cooldown and out of range, so. Either way, Hesta Joe does kill some of these creeps and get back to base. And Meepo actually with a Hex now, completed level 25, so the 400 plus health as well as a DD, so. About to wear off, so not gonna get the benefit of that.
So it looks as though Vega, they're gonna go after these shrines again. C9, they don't look like they want to fight at all. They want to keep the pressure somewhat on Vega, but they just don't want to fight against this Aegis, and they'll try and stay away from Vega as much as they can, farm up what they can, and they do have that Hex out on Ace now, and he's looking for Boots of Travel. It was Scotty before, but he's changed it up to Boots of Travel, so just looking to get that movement availability for him.
Yeah, I'm just trying to stall this game out. So the Silencer slowly creeping up in net worth, and like we said in their in the start of this draft, the Silencer are very, very good versus both of Vega's cores. So if he does get to the point where he actually has a fair amount of core items, could turn grim for Vega very, very quickly with the nets and all the kiting power they have. Looks like maybe setting up down bottom to find a pickup. Let's see.
She is bottom, Sineko off on the wing.
How did they see? But Noya somehow knows that they knew too, and wow, that was so weird.
just TP out. Sema was going to be there with the Icarus dive. They TP out, no fight. And now, actually, Ryze might be in a little bit of trouble. G coming around the back does have that blinking Bloodthorn, so he does want to go for this. There's the Warcry with the Bloodthorn and the Stormhammer. A couple of shots will do it. It's another kill for G. He's now 12-1 as he gets another on Ryze.
Yeah, the wall actually dropped in the top lane. Tried to find Hasuho, just barely gets out. Sneeko slightly missing the kick. And Hasuho able to TP out, finishing up the Hex now as well. So two Hexes on Cloud9. Really playing around this initiation game with the global. First thing heroes taking the fight, you know, very, very quickly. So that Vega doesn't have a chance to just womp heroes down.
So, you think there's anything next for this Sven coming in? Maybe a Moon Shard, just save for buyback for now. He's got boosted travel already, so he can get into the fights. I mean, what do you think his next item is possibly gonna be?
I think a Satanic would be pretty good. An AC, a Butterfly would all be fine. Maybe a Mad Style himself as well, just to keep this kiting low, but he doesn't have enough damage to basically have to be able to one or two shots.
Ace is gonna try and go in there, immediately gonna get the stun on Noya with Dayurok coming out. Silenced up is Ace. Ace might be in a little bit of trouble. He tries to turn this around on Sineko. There's this global silence coming out, but gee, he just hits way too hard for Ace. And that's going to be him going down again. And Meepo dead for 91 seconds. This is going to be a problem for C9. Hopefully Vega, what they're hoping to do is force the buyback out from this Meepo and maybe fight one more time for the win. And they do get the stun. Decrepify does come out, but he's silenced up. Here comes G with the Stormhammer. One shot. There it is. G with another.
Now, Cloud9 just desperately trying to force out these lanes, but Vega very, very aware of what they want to do and just getting pickoff after pickoff as Cloud9 just scrambles to shove these lanes out as far as they can so Vega can't approach the base. But three dead and mid wave in, it looks like what they feared most is about to happen.
They're gonna try and take this mid set of racks. There's God Strength pop by G. Glyph does come out. They're trying to not have to buy back on this Meepo. Well, with this set of racks going down, they might be able to get bottom as well. I feel like at some point you gotta realize as Ace, you gotta buy back and try and stop this. There's the stun coming out on Baby Knight. The buyback is there from Ace, coming with the Icarus dive. Lotus Orb is used, both hexed up. Now there's the Infest with the big vacuum wall onto Ace. Ace might be in a little bit of trouble. He just fought back, and if he goes down, this could all be it, and he will fall. That's 105 seconds with no buyback, and now there's the stun from Hasuho with the Burrow Strike and trying to get that life drain from Pugnum, but not going to be enough as Sineko gets the kill on Ryze. Ryze going to buy back. There's still the wall here. Sema just waiting in the wing. There's the Burrow Strike. It's going to come out on Dira. There's the dust popped. And Arcane Curse is on Sineko, but they try to turn this around. Hexed up is Dira. There's the blink with the Storm Hammer from G. G's going to get himself a kill on Hasuho. They're trying to turn it still, as it will be Mag who gets the kill on Baby Knight, as well as Noya falling, and GG is called by C9. It's completely turned around and crumbled in their faces as Vega take game one.
Yeah, Dayura with some incredible armor toggling in that last fight. Props to him. That was really nice. But yeah, overall, a draft and a game that swung very back and forth throughout it, favoring one draft over another, favoring, you know, and as the game switched, ticked on, favoring one team over another, back and forth, until just a couple of key team fights after that bottom racks happened, that huge five-man wipe, and then just finding pickoff after pickoff for the rest of the game. G getting so many items up this game, 15-1 and 12, 7:30 GPM, and overall, just all of Vega playing extremely well, and understanding exactly how to play around this Meepo lineup, almost slipping out of their control with that bottom fight, but overall, extremely clean game from Vega, and a lot of cool niche picks from Cloud9 as well. So a really good game.
All right, so we're gonna head into game two. Vega looking to clinch the qualification here over C9. C9 looking to save their lives and win this next game. We'll be back in just a moment with game two. I'm your caster, BCop at BCop92 on Twitter. I'm here with CCNC at CCNC Dota 2 on Twitter. We'll be right back with game two in just a moment.